Hello and welcome everyone, I am Vangelis and this is another video tutorial on the Alma CSV User Load Cloud App. This time we're going to analyze the add slash update operation. This is a dual operation, which means that you can either update existing users in Alma or update existing users and create new users at the same time using the same CSV file. We will analyze two examples in this video. The first one is going to focus on updating existing users, so just updating their Alma fields. And the second one is going to demonstrate how to update existing users and create new users at the same time. So let us follow a side-by-side principle by looking simultaneously at the Alma users side-by-side with our CSV file. For the sake of time, I have already prepared some templates, and we can pass on to the hands-on section for the update only operation. So let's see our CSV template. We would like to update three internal users. The first one is Ella Smith, the second one is Chris Doe, and the third one is Joe Jones. These are test users, of course, and something that you need to know and something that's really important. So if you would like to update only existing users with one file, the only important fields, the only important columns in your CSV file are the primary identifier, so the Cloud App will match the primary ID of your users to the users in Alma, and then the Alma fields that you would wish to change. So in this case, we would like to change the preferred language of those three users. So for Ella Smith, who is a native Spanish speaker, we would like to change the preferred language to Spanish. For Chris Doe and Joe Jones, we would like to change the preferred language from English, which is the default, to Dutch. So in fact, the only important columns in our CSV file is the primary identifier, and the preferred language. While the first name and the last name, they are just for our readability. So if our CSV file would just look like this, the Cloud App would still be able to update your users. So let's check our users first and see if their preferred language is indeed English by default. This is Ella Smith, it's an internal user. We see the primary identifier is the same. We did the search based on the primary identifier. And we know, of course, that the preferred language is English for now. So we would like to change that to Spanish. Let's do the same for our other two users. So for Chris Doe, yeah, indeed, the preferred language here is also English. And then for our last user, our last test user, so Joe Jones, the preferred language is indeed English. Okay. So let's just jump immediately to the app. We can see already that there is a green button in our Cloud App Center, which means that we have one suggestion for apps. And this is the Alma CSV user load, of course, because it has to do with the users. So we need to access the settings page by clicking on the three dots menu on the top right corner. And then we're in the settings page, we need to choose the appropriate profile. So we need to just update internal users. The user type is set to internal, of course, and the profile type is the add slash update. So, as we said, this is a dual operation. You can either add and update at the same time or just update, which this is the case in our specific example. So, as you can see, in the field mapping section, we see that only the header of the primary identifier, so the column primary identifier from our CSV file, is mapped to the primary ID, which means that the data from the primary identifier column will match the primary ID in Alma. This is how Alma detects the user that we would wish to update, and then the Alma field that we wish to update. So the column in our CSV file is the preferred language, because we would like to update the preferred language of the users, and this data will update, actually will fill in, will update the data of the preferred language in the Alma field. So let's go to the home page. I like to say that this is the load page, because this is where you can load your users. Let's browse for our file. Okay. We click load users. We confirm yes, we are sure that we want to create or update those three users in Alma. And indeed they are processed. So now what we can do is just confirm by performing a search on those users. Ella Smith should be the language, the preferred language should be in Spanish now. Indeed, the preferred language has been changed. Let's see for our other users. Christo should be Dutch. The preferred language should be set to Dutch. Indeed, the preferred language has changed, as we can see. And let's see for our last user. Indeed, the preferred language has changed to Dutch. So our operation was successful. So let's move on to another example, another hands-on example of add and at the same time update existing users. So we would like to add new users and update existing users. And this is slightly different. In this case, we would need a little bit more detail on that. So let's see. We have two users. We have Chris Doe, that is an external user this time. So those users are external. And for this case, there is again the particularity of the additional ID and so on, something that we will explain very shortly. So we would like, as I have highlighted, we would like to update the address of our external user with the name Chris Doe and the primary identifier external user EU00002 from Willem de Kroeland 55 to Willem de Kroeland 54. And this is what is highlighted here. And at the same time, we would like to add a new user. We would like to create a new user with the name Olivia White with this identifier EU00004. That is a partner, of course. We have explained how the user group is actually assigned. So you need to access the code table. For that, you need to see the previous videos. But broadly, the user group 08 number corresponds to the partner in your institution. This is going to be different, so you need to access the configurations to find out the code of the user group that you would like to assign. She has an email and an email type. Those two go hand in hand together. It's mandatory, as we said, to assign an email type if we would like to assign an email to our users. The same sense for the address and the address type. So if you would like to assign an address to your user, you need to assign an address type. So this is why we have these columns here. We have an expiration date. We have an additional ID type, which is a barcode in our case. 01 means barcode, corresponds to the barcode additional ID in this specific environment. Please note that in your environment, this might be different. So you need to access again the configurations in the admin section to find out which one is your additional ID type and the external system code, because we have to do with external users, we're dealing with external users and we're adding users in this case, we need to include the external system code column. So let's check our users. Let's see first our user based on the primary identifier. Let's check the details for Chris Doe. Indeed, he's an external user. Let's check the contact information. And we see that the preferred address is Willem de Kroeland 55. We want to change that to 54 by updating this specific field. And we would like to add a new user, which probably doesn't exist for now. Indeed, Olivia White doesn't exist for now. We will add her very shortly by accessing the app. So in the Cloud App Center, we access the Alma CSV user load. We go to the settings page. We choose the right profile, which is to add and update external users. Indeed, the user type is set to external, and we wish to add and update at the same time. So in the field mapping, as we said, the header corresponds to the column of your CSV file, and the name corresponds to the Alma field. So the first name is matched to the first name in Alma field. The last name column is matched to the last name. This means that the data from the last name will fill in the data from the last name in Alma. The primary ID to the primary ID. The primary ID in your CSV file will fill in the data of the primary ID in Alma, and so on and so forth. We have a user group, an email type, address, address type, expiration date, an additional ID because this is an external user, and an additional ID type, which is the barcode, because again, it's an external user, and we have an external system code. So let's move on to the home page and try to load the users. We choose the appropriate profile, add and update external users. Now we need to access the template. So we would like to add and update external users. We click load the users, we confirm, we are sure that we want to create or update those two users in Alma. And indeed they are processed. So let's check first if the address has been changed for our user, Christo. We access the contact information tab and we can see that indeed the address has been changed to Willem de Kroeland 54 from Willem de Kroeland 55. And we search for our other user either based on our ID or based on the name, Olivia White. It's the same. Indeed, an external user has been created under this name and under this primary identifier. So, that was the video. Thank you for watching again. Until the next time, stay safe. Bye-bye.